please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America.
And to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Mustangs. Today is Friday, September 10th. I'm Austin, and these are your Dobson announcements. Are you interested in science? Do you want to try fun and an exciting experience you might not get to in your classes? Want to take field trips to fun museums and other science hotspots? Join the Science Club. Meetings will be on Mondays after school in B510 from 3:30 to 4:30. GCU will be at Dobson September 14th during the third hour. If you're interested in hearing more about GCU, you must sign up on the counseling homepage by the 10th to receive a pass to attend. Have you ever wanted to paint some beautiful jazz on a wall? Have you ever do you love street art and want to make responsible for making campus more amazing than it already is? Then you want to check out the Mural Club. The first meeting is today after school in N257. On a more serious note, as some of you may know, tomorrow marks the 20 years since the terrorist attacks on September 11th, 2001. On this day, four airplanes were hijacked and carried out suicidal attacks against the United States. Two of those planes hit the Twin Towers in the World Trade Center in New York City. One of those planes crashed into the Pentagon right outside Washington, D.C., and one crashed into a field in Shanksville, Pennsylvania. During this event, almost 3,000 people were killed. It is safe to say that us students did not experience it, so here are some words from the teachers here at Dobson who did experience this tragedy.
20 years ago, when September 11th happened, I was teaching in a high school in northern Indiana. That the class was quiet, they were doing their testing. I had juniors and seniors at the time. And a faculty member came in to give me a little bit of a break from testing. And they whispered in my ear that the United States was under attack. And I smiled and I kind of laughed because there's no way. There's no way that we had been attacked. I just couldn't believe it. I didn't believe it. So I left and went into the faculty lounge, and I watched as the third plane hit the World Trade Center. And I couldn't believe it, that the United States actually was, in fact, under attack. I stood there for 5 minutes with absolutely no thoughts whatsoever, just in complete disbelief. And yet we were told not to turn on the televisions. We were told not to discuss what was happening because it was a developing situation. Complete and utter disbelief at what was happening. We didn't know the size or the scope. We had absolutely no idea what was happening. I didn't know if we were safe. All I wanted to do was get home to my family and try to figure out what was going on.
So I remember that morning, I was getting ready for work, and I was actually, I think, kind of walking out the door, and we had the news on, and I can't remember what caught my attention, but and maybe it was the smoke coming out of the tower, but I just stood there, and I couldn't. You know, it took me a while to realize that this was real. This was really happening. And nothing else mattered from then on. I wasn't worried about being late for work or it's like you could just feel the whole world stopped.
The most clear thing that I can remember about that day is my stepdad's face. So my stepdad was military intelligence. And so he dealt personally with the types of people who attacked us on that day. And he had just retired. And I remember I was getting ready for school, and my mom and I both were not understanding what was happening. We didn't really know the news anchors at the time that were reporting on it just thought it was an accidental explosion. They didn't know what was going on. And I saw my stepdad's face, and I will never forget the look on his face, because he knew what was going on before anyone else did. He knew what was going on. He never talked about it. He couldn't talk about it. He had such severe PTSD from being in the military that he could never talk about it and be okay. And I think that changed him a little that day too. And it honestly made his PTSD a little worse, if anything else. But I will never forget his face, because he knew, the news anchors didn't know what was going on. When the plane hit the second tower, we watched that happen live on the news. The news anchors didn't even catch on. Nobody knew that it was a second plane, but he knew. I could tell just from his face that he knew exactly what was going on.
Make sure to tell someone you love them. Have a great day in the land of the Mustangs.